very splendid week. Not well, the weather's been brilliant, but also a gentleman, a man that I work with, a very intelligent, motivated, Derek Dasha is with me again. And you know, I keep telling him I'm tired of exciting people, yet you yourself can be here and tell us what is going to be happening.
Well, I mean, it's my birth month, so I decided to make this week very special. Do you know a couple of special?
Do you know about people, people who are born in September?
What
you
is
know
that? Means? What is that?
Their parents started off the new year with a bang.
Exactly! These guys knew what exactly they wanted. So new year, new bang, there you go, kaboom.
Okay.
What's happening? How are you doing?
Fresh as Elvis. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm just trying to, you know, start off the month with a vibrant look, with a happy kind of mood. I don't want stress. So check it out. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us what's happening in the flick.
So tonight on the flick, we are looking at a very interesting movie called The Only Son. And it's directed by Richard Mulindwa, a very good friend of mine. Now, before we get into what this... just a speed dialer.
Okay, cool. Okay, cool.
Now, let me just put you in a situation here. Imagine your dad is very rich man. And then before he actually dies, you know, he has been spoiling you around with money, cars, flashing you here and there. So he decides to teach you a life's lesson. Effects his own imprisonment, whereby they seize all the property, they seize all the accounts, they seize all the cash, and you're literally penless. Or you probably have, you know, like say, let's say 100k. So what's the guys that come bad at the previous night because you're a party pauper, you know, you're just a lover. Exactly. Now you wake up one morning as you're coming back to your home from your bar. And then you find, you know, policemen outside, they're telling you, arresting your father. He has been involved in fraud, corruption here and there, embezzlement of funds. So your father tells you, man, it's about that time. I'm done. So this is where it all ends. No more cash, nothing. So you're in this world alone. Me, I've gone. What would you do?
Oh my God, that kind of question is hard. But me being a hardworking lady and with all the connections I had, don't ask me this question. Don't you come with economics, politics, see?
Of course, for your case, we understand. But now, imagine you are a male, and on this other hand, you have never thought about, you know, the connections. I mean, you've grown up with, you know, with the salary lock, you know, SMS and what. And, you know, you've never thought about, you know, serving numbers.
I turn to
Now, here is what exactly we are talking about in some of what we would like to call the sneak peek over The Only Son.
Hello there. Do you mind a drink? Ah, of course, I know another drink can work for you because a beautiful girl like you in a bar alone. Okay. I believe you don't want to talk to me. Come on. So... Yes, Silas!
Yeah.
Come on, hey, what are you doing here, man?
I'm even here right now.
I'm even surprised you are here too, because I believe you are supposed to be off, yeah?
Yeah, I had to be off, but I'm feeling it for a friend who is...
I get it, right. What?
How have you been doing this? After last night,
do you know
how you made this place go well?
I know, that's my thing.
Do you know we had to restock this morning?
Come on, Silas. You know me. This is me you're talking to, man.
You just amuse me. I don't even know how you're up right now. You should be like having a serious...
You know, I'm so much used to that, yeah?
Anyway, so what should I get you?
So you will take the usual, remember? You know, a little Red Bull and Red Lab, of course.
No problem.
Let's just... Okay.
Anything else?
And yeah, let me have whatever the lady is taking. Oh, please, make it a bottle. So, are you alright? So, what are you doing in a bar alone?
Refreshing up my mind.
Alright. And you're doing that alone?
Yeah.
That's crazy. But anyhow, I'm called D. Davis is mine.
The lady too?
Yeah, a bottle for the lady too. Hope you don't mind.
I don't.
Okay. I say, I'm called D. Davis.
Who is this?
Why are these policemen here?
Can we go, please?
Relax, I'll explain. Come on, talk to me. Why are they here?
Can you please give me 1 minute to talk to my son?
Your son?
Yes.
1 minute.
1 minute. Thank you. Just because I trusted the wrong person. As of now, we have absolutely nothing.
What?
All my property has been seized by Interpol. This whole fraud started in China. And that's why I have to be taken to be charged.
Coming back from that, to make this movie more interesting, is that this young man is actually called on by the uncle from the village. Yes! So the uncle's like, man, things have become tough on your side, but me, I have like a small kafunda in my house, on my land, so come to the village and you see what to do. So from this high-end living to this one, because when we get to the village, it is a madhouse. Things are not doing.
Yeah, no sofa sets, no people to.
You're just on your own, no internet, no electricity. You're back to zero. This is what the young man is going through. Do you think if you are living a flashy life and you're back to zero, do you think that's the kind of life you would handle?
Let me tell you, honestly, thinking, I don't think anyone can. It's hard, but you have nothing. You have to adjust. You understand? Unless you're going to kill yourself. Other than that, you have to adjust. You have to adjust.
It's very hard for one to adjust, especially if you've been living this kind of life of, everything is there.
You can't cry, your dad's in prison. There's no one here to help you.
I mean,
the only person who's offering you is in the village.
He's in the village, but this is the guy who's going to wake up and just leave the house. He has not left food for you. He has not told you where to get food from. He's just literally giving you shelter and telling you when you wake up,
I go to Pastor Bujingos. You know, everything is turned to God. I don't get you people.
But when you turn to God, things don't just move in smoothly. There's always a transition. But anyway, here is, of course, something that happens to this young man the moment he lands in the village. And how does he get to transform? All you can do is catch up with this movie.
Good to see you. Sense of Kulaba. How are you?
You don't know me. I am your uncle, Sebastian.
Oh. Hey.
Nice meeting you, sir.
Nice meeting you. And
I'm Davis.
Daudi.
Thank you very much. That is all we have for you on the flick. After this, we're going for one-on-one with Anisha with the team. Catch you later.